Enable voice authentication. Dr. Emma Fisher, 150412. Try again. Voice authenticate. Dr. Emma Fisher, 140412. There, respond.
I am here.
Oh, thank God. Okay. Now we're getting somewhere. Okay. Sam, you seem to have booted up in Module 8. I'm going to relocate you to the Horizon Utility Hub in Module 9. That should give you access to limited system diagnostics. Hang on. Great. Listen, I'm stuck in the Horizon airlock in Module 11. I need to get into 9, but I'm not sure if it's safe to open this hatch door. Can you give me hull and pressure diagnostics on Module 9?
Module 9 is fully pressurized.
Okay, that's good. Good. Are the adjacent contact points from 9 intact?
Module 9 hull contact points to adjacent modules read true.
Good, we're still connected. Something is vibrating, Sam. Can you check the hull contact points on the other modules?
Module 9 hull contact points to adjacent modules read true.
We know about 9 already.
Module 10, hull contact points to 12, read false, suggesting that Module 12 is no longer securely attached to the station.
Shit. I think Josh might have been in Module 12. Okay. I'm coming through to 9. Sam! The hatch door is jammed shut. The controls aren't responding. See if you can restore power. Sam, you still there? What's going on, Sam? What is that noise? Sam, what is that? Sam, respond! What the hell is going on? Run your self-diagnostic procedure. And what errors are you showing?
Relocation functions are offline. I require auto-routing to access module cameras.
Okay, I can manually relocate you, but once I get out of here, I'll get your systems up and running.
Main memory core has been corrupted. I have lost significant station data.
Okay. So most of your system links and data logs are gone. Sam, you will need to scan, download, and recover as much data as you can. We need to get you back to your old self.
Connection between crew tracker functionality and SAM OS has been severed.
So it's working, but the link is cut. I'll need to reconnect it in Central. Josh? May? Anyone? Shit. Okay. Yeah. I can't get out of here. The hatch controls aren't working. It might be a safety lockdown. You'll have to override the hatch from Module 9. Okay. I'm auto-routing you back to the utility hub in Module 9. Camera movement should be online now. Run a test. Looks good. camera cycling should be active as well. Check the other cameras. Great. I can see your live feed updating from here. There should be a system links reset procedure document on the wall somewhere in there. Find it and scan it. Your scan range is limited, so use your camera zoom to get closer. Installing the system link interface. Use your cameras to locate the hatch controls and any other integrated systems and equipment. Good, good. Looks like that's working. Add another. Okay, now add the EAS-11 airlock hatch controls. Okay, looks like that is working. Now, use your system link interface to open the EAS-11 airlock. That's it. It's open. I'm out. Good work, Sam. Okay. Let's get this up and running. Josh? I don't know if you can hear me, but...
I hate these things. Josh. If you're in EAS Module 12, then stay put. The hull connection isn't secure, and most of our systems are underpowered. I'll work something out. Josh? Houston? Anyone? Wait a minute, Sam. Our internal communication network is fully online. Where has everyone gone? Oh, shit. Okay, station alerts. Right, Sam, you should have access to your OS now.
You can now relocate to any module and view its camera feeds, in the EAS arm at least. Try it now. Find that fire, Sam.
There is a fire out of control in EAS-4.
Shit, I'm on my way.
Sam, the hatch in EAS-6 is locked down. Can you get it open for me? It's open. I'm on my way.
Relocate to EAS-3.
I'll need your help when I get there. EAS-4 hatch controls to your system links, but wait for my signal.
Fire suppression override. Dr. Emma Fisher. Okay, Sam. I need you to get ready and open the door. On three. Are you ready? One. Two. Three. That's it. Come on!
On in here. Clear these fumes. That's it, it's working. The fumes are dissipating now. How bad is it?
The rack units have been damaged beyond any functional use.
Overall, that's not too bad, considering. Started it. What was the source, Sam? We need to stop it happening again.
Residue on panel LFE1. Indicates a potential source.
What? That's just a blank plate. Let me see. Something is coming out of the side. What is that? It's like a thick grease. Or oil. Dark red. There is maybe something in storage above that's leaking. Oh, come on! What now? Sam, give me a status report.
There is significant stress being applied to EAS 12. Immediate separation recommended.
Please, if there is anyone in Module 12, make yourself known now. We are about to jettison the module. Someone, please, respond. This is getting much worse. Okay. Sam, get ready for the separation procedure.
First, process my authorization code and give me a security override key. 1-442-413324. Sam, come on! Authorization. 1-442-413324. Authorization. 1-442-413324.
Two, nine, zero, three, four, one, nine.
Got it. Inputting now. Hurry, Sam. Target the jets and push the module away safely. Weak and distorted. I don't understand. We should be right above Houston. Can you detect any damage, Sam?
EAS-12 is still tethered with unusual structural damage.
It's like a hole has been cut out of it. We must have spun off course. Damage doesn't look too severe. Just isolated sections.
The RU-ARM upper modules are badly damaged.
The damage seems to be localized to the upper part of the arms.
CN arm is badly damaged.
Oh God, May. It looks intact though. I'm going to connect to the distance cam. We should see where we are above Earth and if we've lost any altitude.
I brought you here. It seems.
What? Why?
I don't know.
Started your core systems. You weren't making any sense. And to be quite honest, I'm fucking terrified right now. And anyway, without you, I'm not going anywhere, so. Welcome back. Okay, first off. Let's try this again. Sam, voice authenticate. Dr. Emma Fisher, 140412. Okay. Okay. So, Sam, here's the deal. I'm stuck in the EAS arm for now. I think it's related to power, but a lot of the hatches are fully locked down, so I'm gonna try something different here.
Okay. That's audio, at least. Almost there. Just a sec.
There we go. Okay, Sam. I have rigged a connection sphere for you to use. You should be able to take control of this and fly around the station. It'll let you reach parts of the station your cameras can't see, and it'll let you wirelessly connect to non-station devices, like laptops. There. Looking good, Sam. OK.
okay?
Let's see if you can move it. Fly over to me. Great. Now turn around 180 degrees to face me and fly back. Something isn't right. Hang on.
Try again. Good. Good. There are more controls for translation and rotation, but I'll let you figure them out. You should still be able to identify objects and relay information to me like any other camera. Try it now.
Connection sphere is offline.
Okay, great. That works. Now, you can release yourself from the sphere and return to your main OS just like before. Try it now.
Sphere tracking is online, so its location will be displayed on your station map. To reconnect to your sphere, you can either quick connect directly from your map, or you can use a nearby module camera to access it. Reconnect to your sphere now.
Great. Can't believe that all actually worked. Right. So, the rest of the station is dark, and the Horizon Arm is running on emergency power. The solar panels give us next to nothing this far from the sun. However, we do have an experimental fusion reactor on board, the EFR. If that can generate enough power, we can maybe get the universal hatches open. See what you can do. I'll try to find a way to contact the rest of the crew.
Please repeat your previous request.
Get to the EFR. I think it's in EAS-1, but it might be locked down.
Sam, was that you? I think the backup batteries are struggling to cope. Hang on a sec. Switched off a few other systems, seems to have helped. I don't know how much longer this will last. We need the EFR online. Okay, you should now be able to refer to that schematic to unlock the hatch via your system links. I have no idea how that thing works. It was something Josh was working on. You're pretty much on your own, I'm afraid. Do what you can, just get it online. Now. I'm running low on oxygen.